2017 marks Coach Nick Giaquinto's 29th and final season with Sacred Heart University. The Connecticut native guided the program to their 8th straight NEC appearance in 2016. We spoke with Coach Giaquinto and he expressed his thoughts about his final season and career.
Well, it kind of came on me pretty quickly. One thing is my wife actually moved down to Virginia to take a job. About 2 years ago. So, and I wasn't quite ready then. I still felt like I had some work to do, and we had a good bunch of guys coming in, so I wanted to stick around for at least another 2 years. And it definitely seems like the right time.
The players have really connected with their coach, and junior pitcher James Tobble definitely has a memory of his own of Coach Giaquinto.
I think my most favorite memory of Coach G would be, you know, my freshman year we won the NEC tournament, and after we won, we came back in the championship game in the 9th inning. It was a crazy game. And after we won, after we dogpiled and celebrated, we, you know, got to pour the Gatorade on him, and it was a special moment, because knowing that, you know, this, you know, he's only got a few of those left because this is his last year. So, you know, it was really exciting to see his expression and see how proud he was of us, and to show that, you know, he's led us to this point.
For junior outfielder Dan Schock, the environment surrounding his final season at Sacred Heart will feel different without Giaquinto.
It's going to be a lot different, obviously, with new guys stepping in and a new philosophy, but Coach G has been a great guy for 3 years. I know he's been a great guy before that, but personally I've known him for 3 years, and it's been a huge help to me, like, as a player and as a person.
As players have come and gone throughout his tenure at Sacred Heart, Giaquinto has seen the baseball program steadily evolve over time.
When I took over the team, it was Division II, and that was in 1988, the fall of 88. And the team was, you know, around 500 for the previous few years. And first year, we were around 500. And then the next 3 years, we made it to the Division II regionals. And in 92, we made it to the national championship. So after that, 93, 94, we were pretty solid. And then in 95, we started all this growth and started adding sports. And at that time, basketball was going to the regionals a lot, softball was. But then with the expansion, athletics was de-emphasized in one respect as far as scholarships goes, but it was tremendously, it was built to what it is now, 32 varsity sports. So, you know, we took a hit for a little while, but then once we became Division I, we started getting back on a roll and being competitive.
The 2-2. This is a fly ball into right. Boister calls for it. He makes the squeeze, ball game. For the second time in history, or the first time since 2006. The Sacred Heart Pioneers are Northeast Conference baseball champions. Fly ball, foul ground on the left side. Phillips is there, he makes the catch, and the ball game is over. Your winners and still champion, the Sacred Heart Pioneers. Sacred Heart takes home their second straight title.
And Wirtz deals. Chopper to Zach Short. Here's the throw, down on the bag, and it is over. No heartbreak this year for the Pioneers. Sacred Heart, the NEC baseball champions here in 2015.
That competitiveness Giaquinto experienced included the Pioneers winning a total of 4 NEC championships, which is tied with Central Connecticut and Monmouth for the most all time. Sacred Heart made it to 7 straight NEC championship games from 2009 to 2015, winning 3 out of 5 from 11 to 15. But perhaps the most fascinating accomplishment of Coach Giaquinto's career isn't on the baseball diamond.
Not the only thing here. Touchdown. Did he work for that one? Yes, he did. Because he carried that entire drive by himself. And for a guy who hasn't played that much regularly, he has got to be gasping for air.
Giaquinto played in the National Football League from 1980 to 1983.
It was tremendous. It was a dream come true, you know, for any athlete. It's to win that world championship. So I had, worked hard to become a professional football player. I actually got cut my first 3 years trying out. So I didn't make it to my fourth year. Made the Miami Dolphins in 1980. And then in 81, I ended up getting cut in the middle of the year, picked up with the Redskins. So in 82, we win the Super Bowl. So it was just a tremendous experience for me. I was very fortunate to be in the right place at the right time.
Giaquinto thought he would always coach football, but after retiring from the NFL, he had the passion to coach baseball instead.
I just decided to shift gears because I did play a year of college baseball and played baseball growing up. So I was fortunate enough to be an assistant at George Mason University for 2 years while I got my master's there. And when I started with them, like I said, I hadn't been in baseball for a little while. And I just was more like the mental training coach, you know, just kind of help the guys just stay locked in, stay focused. And I would go to clinics, go to conventions, pick former coaches' brains that I knew, and just kind of kept, trying to learn, as I continue, still trying to learn every year. So it was that. And then I got this job when my third year. Coach Bike was actually the athletic director at the time, Dave Bike, who our court is named after, the basketball coach for many, many years. So Dave hired me, and since then it's just been great.
Assistant coach and recruiter Nick Restaino will succeed Giaquinto as head coach next season. The players are optimistic about the transition and are looking forward to playing for Restaino.
I think he's going to do a great job. He's had a lot of experience at Fordham, and as a head coach he had a lot of success there, and you know, I think he's going to do a really good job with the program.
Yeah, I'm very excited to play for Coach Restaino. We have a good relationship, me and the team, with him, so I think he's going to come in and do a great job right off the bat.
And as for what the future holds for Coach Giaquinto?
Next is a big question mark. There are some things that I'm kind of sure of. I'm actually going to be coaching a summer team down at Virginia Beach. And I'll be working at a batting cage, you know, towards the middle of the summer on that. Also have a couple other things that I'm working on, but nothing specific that is worth talking about right now. So it's an exciting time. It's a little scary, but it's exciting. And I'm just ready.
I'm Ryan Cerruto, and along with Ryan Tuohy, thanks for watching our Sports Package 2017.